Your time has come at last, dear reader. While we began this tale long ago, we hope it is yours to finish. But this story is not yours alone. No, it is tied to another. And the journey you take together, they called it the Cinder Knight. What came from those dark, starless skies would change the world of Moss forever. The peace that had settled across the land was broken by an unconquerable nightmare. And that night, the animals nearly met their end. First, they killed the king. A winged creature broke from the shadows and plucked him from his royal bedchamber high atop the tallest tower. Next, the serpent Sarfog and the armies of the Arcane tore up from the underworld. They ravaged the king's guard fought bravely, but the castle soon pulsed with the Arcane's evil. Every room was gutted, every statue, tapestry, and adornment hexed. But the glass was never found. Even the recluse. Meanwhile, Sir Argus, commander of the King's Guard, led the survivors west through a temple long abandoned by their ancestors and far away from their newly risen enemies. It was an Argus charged back to join the Sprite champion at the Mire's edge. Together, they fought back the Arcane and sealed the temple passage that led to the clearing. She was not exactly sure what she roused, but she felt no danger from the being silently peering down at her. Quill had to hurry. The village gates would soon close, and night would follow. Night, her uncle often warned, was when danger was most present. But Quill preferred the stories of the magical creatures that woke to protect the forest. Thank you. thanks to her new friend, Quill had saved priceless grains from the hourglass. She raced to the door of the cottage she shared with her uncle, hoping once he saw her discovery, he'd lose himself in tales of its legend. Uncle Argus was watching the evening light dim when Quill burst through the front door of their cottage.
Uncle! Uncle, there's something you have to see!
Out past the bell again, he scolded. Quill, I've told you countless times.
I know, Quill replied, crestfallen. I didn't mean to worry you, but I found something strange and magical. Quill's hands trembled as she showed him the glass.
What is it?
She asked. A look of panic spilled over her uncle's stoic exterior.
Where did you find this?
Roared Uncle Argus. Quill had never seen her uncle so shaken.
Just west of the clearing,
she explained. And as soon as I picked it up, something started...
Even with the moon. I'll be back before midnight. Until I return, I need your word you will not leave the clearing with that glass.
Hey, kid! Kid! Wake up! Hey, kid, over here! I know where your uncle went. I can show you. You're twofold now. Very important. Bring that glass and your sidekick, too. We're going to need them.
Quill called out.
Hey! Starling, wait!
Quill had never met a Starthing. In campfire stories, they often meddled in the lives of mortals. And when they appeared, mischief followed. Passage through the Eastern Gate was strictly forbidden. But despite her promise, Quill knew in her heart that Uncle Argus needed her. Quill demanded answers.
Starthing, you can't just barge in here with your riddles. Where is he? What do you know? The trouble your uncle's heading for is the kind only you and that silent giant up there can get him out of. This way, kid,
urged the Starthing. And don't forget to tuck your ears in.
Thank you.
just on the other side is the mire,
the Starling assured her.
There's a good chance your uncle's still there. Did you hear that?
The Starling seemed anxious.
I've ruffled enough leaves in these parts. I can't be seen with you. I'll catch up with you later. Just don't go and die on me.
A whisper echoed through the trees.
Fought like someone who has stolen our champion's power.
A small yet fent. She sized up Quill with a roof. Quill stepped closer.
Your uncle once took a solemn oath to protect. Take these. Weapons made for the mighty champion who died so that...
Quill's favorite story. How Sir Argus fought beside the Sprite Champion to seal this temple from the Arcane and secured the survival of their kinds. Simply standing in their heroic footsteps felt like a great honor.
Thank you. If Veda knew I led you here, she'd burn my roots from existence.
A voice rose from the soil, gently shaking the branches.
But I need to know you can handle the perils of the castle. No animal has ever crossed into a sprite's heartwood. The words radiated from the leaves. You must prove I've not erred in giving you the glass relic.
Thank you.
start, but we'll have more work to do if Vada is ever going to accept you as her champion. I'll summon you again when you're ready.